वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल 24/7 एपी लाइब्रेरी। टुडे वी आर विद यू विद अनदर वीडियो ऑफ इंग्लिश ग्रामर टॉपिक प्रोनाउन। सम सेंटेंसेस यू आर seeing on the screen. First is, my name is Paramveer Singh. I live in Gittadbaha. We like to eat pizza. Next is, he likes to play cricket. She is a doctor. They are singing a song. All these sentences have at least one highlighted word that is in blue color. All these words are used in place of any noun. Any name should be there, but we use these words instead of the nouns. Now, the definition of pronoun. From the previous examples, we can understand that a pronoun is a word used in place of a noun or a noun phrase. To avoid the repetition of noun or noun phrase means which words we have used in place of nouns, those are pronouns. For example, two sentences are there on your screen. Mr. Paramveer Singh teaches English. He teaches English. In the second sentence, he is a pronoun that takes the place of the noun Mr. Paramveer Singh. This word replaces the noun, that's why this is pronoun. Some more examples. Arun is a magician. He is very famous. Here we have used he in place of Arun in place of noun to avoid the repetition of noun word. So he is pronoun here. Next is, Seema is a nurse. She takes special care of patients. Here, she is used in place of noun Seema. So, this is pronoun. This is also used to avoid the repetition of a noun word. Next is, apple is red. It is very sweet. Here, apple is noun in first sentence and it is used in place of apple to avoid its repetition. To avoid the repetition of noun. So, it is a pronoun. Pronoun, the word or phrase to which a pronoun refers is called its antecedent. A pronoun must agree with its antecedent in number, person, and gender. If the noun is singular, then the pronoun must be singular. And if noun is plural, then the pronoun used at the place of that noun, that must be in plural. Same in case of gender, in case of male or female. A singular pronoun replaces a singular noun, and a plural pronoun replaces a plural noun. Next is kinds of pronouns. There are 7 kinds mentioned here on your screen. First is personal pronoun. Second is possessive pronouns. Third is reflexive or emphasizing. Fourth is demonstrative. Fifth is indefinite. Sixth is interrogative. And seventh is relative. Very first kind is personal pronouns. Personal pronouns refers to specific person or thing. For example, I, me, you, he, him, she, her, it, its, they, them, we, us. Here we take it and its as personal pronoun, but these words we use for things and for animals. Arun reads stories. He likes fairy tales. The word he is personal pronoun that refers to a person named Arun. So this is personal pronoun. Next, second kind is possessive pronouns. Possessive pronouns are used to show the ownership of any person over anything. These are used without the nouns, unlike the possessive adjectives. Means these are used alone without any noun. For example, mine, ours, yours, his, hers, theirs. These are the examples of possessive pronouns which are used alone without any noun. Reflexive or emphasizing pronouns. These pronouns end with self or selves as suffixes. Singular pronouns end with self, self suffix. Plural pronouns end with selves, like myself, himself, herself, themselves, ourselves. And reflexive emphasizing pronouns. These are two different kinds also in pronouns. Words are same in reflexive and in emphasizing pronouns, but the use of these two kinds is totally different. Reflexive pronouns are used after the action words or verbs. But emphasizing pronouns are used before the action words or verbs. So this is the difference between these two kinds of pronouns. Words are same in both, but use of these two is different in sentence. Here is a table to clarify your doubts regarding pronouns. Here in this table you can see personal pronouns, possessive pronouns, reflexive or emphasizing pronouns, and possessive adjectives also. And here we have the classification of first person, second person and third person. In personal pronouns, in first person we use I, we, me, us. In possessive pronouns we use as first person mine, ours. In reflexive or emphasizing pronouns we use myself or ourselves. Now second person. In second person, in personal pronouns we use you. In possessive pronouns we use yours. And in reflexive or emphasizing pronouns we use yourself. In third person we have he, she, they, him, her, them. In personal pronouns, in possessive pronouns we use his, hers, theirs. And in reflexive or emphasizing pronouns we have himself, herself, themselves. Now in personal pronouns we have two columns. First column we use as a subject in the sentence. Second column we use as an object in a sentence. Now possessive adjectives and possessive pronouns. My is possessive adjective and mine is possessive pronoun. Because adjectives are used to tell the noun and pronouns are used in place of noun. So mine is used alone, so this is possessive pronoun. With my we use any noun, any other word, any noun we use with my word. So this is possessive adjective because it tells us about the noun. So this is the difference between possessive adjectives and possessive pronouns. In reflexive and emphasizing pronouns we have discussed in previous slide. Next is demonstrative pronouns. Demonstrative pronouns point out specific persons or things. When we point out something like this, that, these, those, these are demonstrative pronouns. And these all four words are used as demonstrative adjectives also. When these are used alone without any noun, then these are demonstrative pronouns. When these are used with any noun, then these are demonstrative adjectives. Next is indefinite pronouns. Indefinite pronouns refer to one or more unspecified persons, things or objects. Let's see the examples of indefinite pronouns. Someone, anyone, nobody, nothing, etc. Words ending with one or body are used for people, and ending with thing are used for things. Next is interrogative pronouns. Interrogative pronouns are used to introduce the questions and refer to the nouns we don't know. For example, who, whom, whose, what, which, etc. Next is relative pronouns. Relative pronouns appear in complex sentences and refer to a noun in main clause. About complex sentences also we will know in our next videos. So stay tuned to our channel. Here are some examples of relative pronouns: who, whom, which, that, whose, whoever, whichever. These are the examples of relative pronouns. These are used in complex sentences, not to ask questions. When we use who to ask a question, then that is interrogative pronoun. When we use it in complex sentences, then this is relative pronoun. Now let's see some more examples of pronouns. First is she is dancing. Here she is pronoun. You are a tall boy. Here we have you as pronoun. He is a fat man. Here we have he as a pronoun. Fourth is she is a pretty girl. Here we have she as a pronoun. Fifth is they are best friends. Here we have they as a pronoun. Sixth is I have invited them for dinner this weekend. Here we have I and them as pronouns in this sentence. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned to our channel for our next videos and subscribe our channel 24/7 AP Library for more videos, and press the bell icon for instant notifications for our next videos. Thank you.